Hello, and welcome back to another episode of our motor glider restoration. This time we will start covering the fuselage, but there are some small jobs that we need to do first. The first of those jobs is to make a hole in the wheel well for the main wheel. This hole is used to feed the cable from the air brake lever to the main wheel brake assembly. There was a hole in the wheel well when we got it, but over time this hole got a very weird shape and we decided to just make it look a little bit nicer. And since we took out the wheel well, it might not be exactly in the same location anymore after putting it back. So we carefully measured the location of the brake lever on the wheel assembly and drilled the hole. Later we will increase the size of this hole to make sure everything runs smoothly. The next thing we had to do is feed some preliminary wires through the control sticks. These wires will be connected to the transmit button on top of them. We tried to use some steel wire to pull another steel wire from the bottom of the control sticks to the top. This was quite a fiddly thing. After we got the steel wire through, we pulled some temporary PVC cable from the bottom to the top. We will later use this wire to pull Tefcel wire from the top to the bottom, as the insulation on this wire is made from PVC, which is not allowed in aircraft. The wire we will eventually use for the switches is Tefcel, a Teflon coated wire. Another thing we really had to do before we could start covering the frame is to make new rudder control cables. Once the frame is covered, it will be nearly impossible to feed this cable through their guides without cutting open the fabric, which of course is not what we want. We got the original rudder cables with the plane and they were in a reasonable condition, but since this is basically our only chance to replace them, we decided to do so. The rudder cables are made of 3.2mm diameter steel cable and they have a loop at both ends. One of these loops connects to the rudder pedals and the other one connects directly to the rudder in the back. These loops can be made by pressing a bushing with a special plier, as you can see here. The inside of the loop is reinforced with a special metal ring. Once everything is in the right place, the bushing is crimped with special pliers. The original cables had 3 crimps for each bushing, so we did the same. As you can see, it takes quite a bit of force to crimp these bushings, but it's vital that they are tight. For now, we will only make the loop on the side of the rudder pedals. Later, we will be able to determine the exact length and make the loop for the rudder as well. We can then mount the cable to the rudder control pedals and feed it through all the guides all the way to the back of the plane. The cable is held in place on the rudder pedals with 2 rings and a nut. This nut is not a self-locking nut, it's secured with a split pin. This means that the bolt that's welded to the rudder pedals has a hole in it. You tighten the nut as far as you want, and then you put the pin through this hole. You can then bend this pin, such that it doesn't fall out. The pin then prevents the nut from rotating all the way to the end of the bolt, thus securing it. These guides are metal tubes that are welded to the airframe, and they have a nylon bushing pressed into them to avoid metal-on-metal contact. As you can see, there are quite a bit of these guides from the front to the back of the plane. Currently the cable is still slack, but this will be resolved when the rudder is on the plane. The glass fiber cover that we mounted to the top of the frame in a previous episode still has to be sanded. There's some old paint on it and it's not entirely smooth. We also filled the gap that was left after mounting the cover with Vigant epoxy. This is the place where the previous owners cut the glass fiber cover in half to be able to remove it. After this Vigant epoxy was dry, we sanded it to make it flush with the rest of the cover. Also, the glass fiber covers in the front of the plane needed some sanding. During sanding, we found some small cracks in the glass fiber, and we decided to repair these. To do so, we cut a bit of glass fiber cloth to size. And then glued it in place using epoxy. It does not matter too much that this repair is not entirely flush with the cover, as we will apply a lightweight filler to make everything smooth before painting. Finally, we apply two component paint to the underside of the front glass fiber covers. And we did some final sanding on the main wheel well. After these small jobs, the plane is ready for covering. Recently, Schaeber Aircraft released a service bulletin, ETM in German, which allows recovering of Schaeber Aircraft with synthetic covering materials. Previously, they were covered with some kind of cotton fabric. This TM is both good and bad. The good is that it's now legal to use synthetic fabric. The bad thing is that we have to use more expensive materials. As you can see, the TM prescribes that we need to use glue and finishing lacquer from Schaeber Aircraft. They also prescribe that you buy a work instruction from them, which is good and actually quite helpful. This is the official Schaeber glue that needs to be used. It's quite expensive. We almost spent as much on glue and finishing lacquer as that we spent on the aircraft, including all the parts and the engine. We first rotate the plane to get better access to the area that we want to cover. In this case, the area around the main wheel fairing. This glue needs to be applied in several layers. Each layer needs to dry in between. The work instruction does not specify a number of layers, but they do specify a minimum thickness. Since this is hard to measure in some cases, they use the guideline that the dried glue should look shiny, as if it were just applied. We probably applied at least 6 layers to the fuselage, which takes quite long, so here's a time lapse. With a sufficiently thick layer of glue applied to all of the required tubes, we can start covering. The instructions specify to start around the main wheel fairing, so this is what we do. We first cut the piece of covering material to roughly the right size. Note that the glue does not stick anymore at this point. You can move the cloth freely. To keep it roughly in the right place, we use some clamps. We can then start pasting the fabric to the tubes of the frame. This is done by soaking a cloth in solvent, the same as used in the glue. You can then apply the wet cloth to the covering fabric, which locally makes the glue stick again. As there's now only some solvent to evaporate, this dries very fast. You then go around all the tubes of the frame that have glue applied to make the fabric stick to it. The fabric should be applied with relatively few wrinkles and folds, but it does not to be entirely free of them, as this material has a trick up its sleeve. When the fabric is applied, we take a hot air blower and carefully heat up the fabric. This will cause it to shrink and take out all of the wrinkles. Care must be taken though to not overheat the fabric or the glue underneath it. After a while, the fabric is nicely tensioned around the airframe, which allows us to continue with the next bit of fabric. From this point on, covering the other side of the wheel fairing and the bottom of the fuselage is roughly the same process. Therefore, a little montage to cover all of the work that we did. One tricky bit with covering the bottom of the airplane is that we need to make a cut where the wheel fairing is. Next to the wheel fairing, we need to stick fabric to fabric. We thus needed to apply more glue to the outside of the fabric that we glued earlier. While doing this, we must take care that we do not unglue the fabric underneath. After a lot more shrinking with the hot air blower, we end up with this nicely tightened fabric on the bottom of the airplane. However, there are a few areas that we want to reinforce. And of course, we still need to cover the sides. There are still a little bit more processing steps, also on this fabric. But we can only do that once all the other fabric has been applied to the fuselage. We will continue with that in the next episode. I hope you liked this video and maybe even learned something. If you did, please like this video, or even better, subscribe to this channel to make sure that you don't miss any future updates. Well, that's it for now. See you next time.